मॉड्यूल 17 आई डॉक्टर रीता प्रताप एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ड्राइंग एंड पेंटिंग यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ राजस्थान आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक ऑन पेंटिंग इन द डेक्कन अहमदनगर एंड बीजापुर Although no pre-Mughal painting is known at present from the Deccan kingdoms, from what is found when examined the earliest documents which are of the period of the formation of Mughal style. It is clear that there was in Deccan an active sophisticated school flourishing there with a style strong enough to contribute significantly to the Mughal style. Moreover, it continued independent of the Mughal style for another 100 years. To the south, beyond the Mughal domains, the Punjab hills and Rajasthan lies the Deccan Plateau. During the early 14th century, this region was conquered by Muslims from the North India, among whom were peoples from Persia, Central Asia and Afghanistan, who were Turkish speaking. In 1347, a Bahman Shah, a Muslim officer serving in Deccan, rebelled against the Delhi Sultanate and founded an independent Sunni Muslim dynasty which extended from Vindhyachal Mountains in the south, Arabian Sea in the west and Bay of Bengal in the east. For about 150 years, the Bahamanids were in power. That is, by the end of 15th century, the then governor established 5 sultanates in the Deccan: Ahmednagar, Bidar, Berar, Bijapur, and Golconda. These new Muslims were from different backgrounds. For example, the sultans of Golconda were descendants of a black sheep, Turkman Kulli Qutub Shah, who fled to India in 1467 AD, when his Granian kingdom was conquered by white sheep Turkman. The Sultan of Ahmednagar was a Hindu slave who had converted to Islam, and the Bijapur rulers traced their origin to an Ottoman Turk who took shelter in the Deccan. But the rulers of these 3 major sultanates, Golconda, Bijapur, and Ahmednagar, patronized artists. Ahmednagar. The kingdom of Ahmednagar enjoyed independence for a more shorter period than Bijapur and Golconda. Its painting is the rarest of the Deccan schools. It is said that the Turkman princes with artisans and painters had immigrated from Tabriz to Deccan in the late 15th century, setting the tone for Deccani art until the Mughal conquest. During the late 16th century, a brief flowering of arts took place under the patron of 3 sultans: Hussain Nizam Shah, who ruled from 1554 to 1565, and his sons Murtaza I, ruled from 1565 to 1588, and Burhan II, ruled from 1591 to 1595. These 3 sultans were not only patron of arts, but their reign also provided a period of political stability. A small group of brilliant portraits, mainly drawings, can be ascribed to their periods. Among the earliest found paintings are the 12 illustrations assigned to the history of the reign of Hussain Nizam Shah I, entitled the Tarif-e-Hussain Shahi, produced in 1565 and now in the collection of Bharat Itihas Samshodhak Mandal, Pune. These are rendered in a brightly colored combination of Persian and indigenous Indian styles. This is a poetic account written by Aftabi in Persian style. This manuscript is unfinished and does not have a colophon. The Tarikh describes the virtues of Hussein and his wife Khanzada Humayun. The defeat of Vijayanagar army is illustrated and described. In the 12 illustrations, the queen appears in 6 of them with her husband. The 5 paintings depict court scenes in which indistinct form shares Sultan Hussein Nizam Shah's throne. Sultan Hussein Nizam Shah enthroned, a page from the Tarikh Hussein Shahi. Another page from the Tarikh is a tree blossoming at the Queen of Ahmednagar's touch, shows the ancient Dohad theme. Another drawing in the collection of Salarjung Museum, Hyderabad, shows a huge man, Sultan Hussein Nizam Shah, approaching a tiny elephant and mahout. The elongated face, oversized jewelry, tall and slender figures draped in saris that cross their breasts in southern fashion are Deccani inventions. Sultan Murtaza Nizam Shah's reign, dated to 1565 to 1588 AD, is said to be the longest period of peace and stability during the second half of 16th century. And the classic moment of Ahmednagar school occurred during his reign. It was also the cultural zenith of the kingdom when poets Urfi and Zahuri immigrated from Iran to Ahmednagar. The youthful appearance of the Sultan in both portraits is more appropriate for a portrait of Murtaza in 1570s when he was in his 20s than of Burhan, who at the age of 35 ascended the throne. Attributed to the Paris painter are Sultan Murtaza Nizam Shah enthroned and Sultan Murtaza Nizam Shah relaxing, dated to 1572 AD and 1575 AD respectively. The paintings of Paris portrait bears a rough Persian inscription on the reverse which reads Burhan Nizam al-Mulk and Tar-e-Oval-e-Deccan, the earliest Deccani work. Another painting painted by Paris painter is a young prince riding a horse dated to 1575 AD. A young prince may be Sultan's son of 12 or 13 years old, is riding on horse with full of excitement through a golden field having stylized plants. He is wearing the familiar white muslin jama over blue pajama. After Murtaza's death in 1588, his son Hussein ruled for 1 year. His age at that time was 16 or 17 years. He was succeeded by his cousin Ismail, who ruled from 1589 to 1591 AD, who was 10 years when he ascended to the throne. To a slightly later phase of Ahmednagar, say to the period of Murtaza's brother Burhan II, who ruled from 1591 to 1595, belongs some line drawings with some color. During Murtaza's reign, Burhan had spent years of exile at the court of Mughal Emperor Akbar, and it is possible that the style of painting which he patronized after his return was strongly influenced by the Mughal taste. The line drawing of a painting running elephant, dated to 1590 to 95 AD, in an American private collection has the same decorative patterns as found in the paintings of the period of Akbar. That is, the elephant's coiled trunk, curved tail, and stripped hide. The other drawing, the Royal Picnic, dated to 1590 to 1595 AD in India Office Library, London, depicts Burhan Nizam Shah himself, who is seated in a canopied throne, set out in a garden, listening to singers, and on the other side, the servants lay a sumptuous feast. After Burhan's death in 1595, there were series of child kings like Sultan Ahmed, 1595 AD, and Bahadur, 1595 AD, and Sultan Ibrahim, 1595 to 1600 AD. The drawings of royal youths probably depict these unfortunate kings. Young prince embraced by a small girl, dated to 1580 to 1595. The prince is kneeling on the floor, laid with elegant trays of food, drink, and pan, and a tiny girl is embracing. Another drawing of a young prince kneeling, dated to 1580 to 1595, is also of the same type. The beardless face closely in resemblance to Mir Sayyid Ali type. It seems the artist must have been trained by him in India or in Iran. Malik Ambar ruled from 1600 to 1626. Dictator of Ahmednagar, was former African slave who as a child was sold to an Arab merchant in Baghdad. Traveling to Deccan, Malik quickly rose in Ahmednagar service, supporting Abhang Khan, another African. Malik set up a Nizam Shahi ruler, Murtaza II, who ruled from 1600 to 1610, appointed himself prime minister and managed to reconquer most of the kingdom by 1605 AD. Married the young king to his own daughter, and by 1605 AD managed to reconquer almost all the kingdoms. Malik Ambar is said to be a generous patron of the arts, and he founded and embellished the city of Kirki. 9 paintings are attributed to Ahmednagar during the turbulent 40 years, among which 8 of them depict African and one young fair-skinned prince, that is Malik Ambar, wearing a diaphanous white jama, Ahmednagar, dated to 1610 AD. Fateh Khan Malik, Ambar's son, and Sultan Burhan Nizam Shah, Ahmednagar, are in the collection of Museum of Fine Arts, Boston. To conclude, it can be said that all these kingdoms had their own styles and they shared a general Deccani approach to painting. Most of the Deccani artists preferred lyrical portraits, Persian literary themes, and occasional depiction to musical modes, to the historical events and realistic likeness so dear to the Mughals. They worked in styles that combined in varying proportions the delicate rhythm of Persia, the lush sensuality of South India, and exotic elements taken from Europe and Turkey. Portrait of Burhan Nizam Shah II of Ahmednagar, dated to 1591 to 1595 AD. The portrait done in Ahmednagar, especially Burhan Nizam Shah, have definite affinities with the imperial manner of Agra and Sikri, except that the further eye is retained here. The 3/4 profile has probably come from the Lipakshi tradition. The bright colors, vermilion and dark green, are from Deccan and golden dust of the background, but the softer shades are adapted from Mughal paintings. Another painting, Vasant Rag, belonging to Ahmednagar, dated to 1577, is From the Ragini to the Vasant Raga of Ahmednagar, dated to 1591 to 1595. The translation is even more accomplished. A lovely fantasy world is created. The prince and his beloved are shown on the swing bed with two maids shooting color on the couple. The third maid is about to sing. The treatment of the round trees with white blossoms and birds with bits of bright fruit gives emotional depth to the lyrical pink background. The golden sky contrasts with the black hexagonal pond. The spring festival of Holi creates a warm feeling of abandon. Dohad scene from Tarif-e-Hussain Shahi in praise of Sultan Hussein, painted under his queen Khanzada Humayun. Hinduized costume with scarf reminiscent of Mandu. The painting is a mixture of the Persian and the Deccan pictorial elements with some influence of the Mandu Niyamat Nama. The figures are idealized woman in Hindu costumes, the stripped scarf which the servant is fanning the queen, the legend by which a tree blossoms at the embrace or touch of a woman called Dohad. Another portrait entitled Lord of the Deccan to be Murtaz II, dated to 1602 to 1630. This painting is of a sleeping prince, perhaps Murtaza II, the peacock-like feather of the foliage, the gold used on the costume and jewelry, as well as utensils indicate prosperity in Ahmednagar court. Bijapur. The rulers of Bijapur patronized painting during 16th and 17th centuries. Pictures were produced at Bijapur from 1560 to 1686 AD. A variety of artistic traditions, indigenous, Indian, Persian, Mughal, Turkish, and European, contributed to the evolution of Bijapur painting style. Before the reign of Sultan Ali, Adil Shah I, Bijapuri, who ruled from 1557 to 1579, no painting has been found which can be attributed to Bijapur. Bijapur's cultural identity seesawed again on the succession of Ibrahim's son, Ali I, who was more fanatically Shia than his grandfather. Rafi-ud-Din, Tad-Pirat al-Mulk, gives an account of Bijapur from his origins to 1612. The author, a Persian who came to Bijapur during the reign of Ibrahim II, says that Ali had great inclination towards study of books and he had procured many books connected with every kind of knowledge. Nearly 16 men, calligraphers, gilders of bookbinders and illuminators were busy doing their work the whole day in the library. Few paintings which can be attributed to Ali's reign are Nuzum al-Ulum or Stars of Science. The book, a compilation with 876 illustrations, are on facts, on astronomy, magic animals and weapons. Some occupy a full page, others are marginal decorations. The pages are in Chester Beattie Library, Dublin, dated to 1570 AD. It must be due to Bijapur's close connection with Turkey, and the astronomical illustrations in this book may well derive from an Ottoman Turkish manuscripts such as the work of Fuzuli. An example from Nuzum al-Ulum, The Throne of Prosperity, folio 191, rects, dated to 1570, is a symbolic diagram of a propitious throne of seven stages, each supported by its characteristic inhabitants. from elephants and tigers to palm trees through stories of peacocks and primitive tribes. These friezes of little figures recall the wood-carved house fronts of Gujarat or the step risers of the temples of the Deccan with the friezes of elephants. The coloring of this page is in the Islamic Persian tradition, especially the arabesque, the top of the throne, but this is surrounded by a purely Deccan piece of foliage against the deep blue sky. The stylized plants on either side of the throne recall the margin decoration in Gujarati manuscript of early 16th century date. Jawahir al-Muskiyat-e-Muhammadi is another manuscript set of 48 paintings on music and dance. It is a lively version of Nujoon style. Another musical manuscript, Ragmala, a Marathi commentary on Srangdev's Sangeet Ratnakar, is in the collection of City Palace Museum, Jaipur. This commentary was commissioned by Kishan Singh, the son of Maharaja of Amer, who was then in Mughal service in Deccan. The page from Rasa Pradipa Tika dated 1570 shows the prince watching dance performance. Another painting connected with Adil Shah's reign is a portrait of Ali himself dressed in gold brocade shawl over a white muslin jama dated 1570 in London's collection. Sultan Ibrahim Adil Shah II Bijapuri, who ruled from 1579 to 1627 AD. He was one of the greatest patron of arts the Deccan produced, seeking artists from all over the world. At the age of 20, when he assumed full power, Bijapuri paintings suddenly erupted. His artists intuitively responded to his sensitivity to real feats of genius, whether in literature, music, or painting. Deccan paintings probably intrigued and pleased both Akbar and Jahangir, accustomed to the realism and restraint of Mughal art. For at least two Mughal painters, Muhammad Ali and Farooq Beg, painted in Presidio Deccan style. Portrait of Sultan Ibrahim Adil Shah II Bijapuri dated to 1590 and Procession of Ibrahim Adil Shah II Bijapuri dated to 1595 is attributed to a Bikaner painter. By 1600, two broad strands had developed within the Bijapuri school. Some artists were more sensitive to Turco-Iranian taste and the traditional Islamic arabesque and the paradise garden sitting to lyrical effect. Others like Bikaner artist and the Niyamat Nama artist, earthier and more Indian, used the idealized human body as a means of expression. The true traditions merged in many paintings during the following decades. The Niyamat Nama manuscript or the Book of Dantes in the State Museum, Hyderabad, dated 1600 to 1610, contains recipes for Indian foods and perfumes in Persian prose and poetry. In this painting, Sultan is shown seated in a garden surrounded by musical instruments while servants offer him food and drink. Attributed to the Baldian painter Bijapur, 1610 to 1620 AD, and in the collection of British Museum, London, is the painting of Sultan Ibrahim Adil Shah II holding castanets. It dates to 1610 AD. Other paintings attributed to the same artist is of kneeling dervish, fighting cranes and royal falcon. Moreover, artists employed by Sultan Ibrahim Adil Shah II created lush, mysterious and introspective compositions. During the period of Sultan Muhammad Adil Shah Bijapuri, dated to 1627 to 1656 AD, Mughal and Rajput princes came to live in the Mughal Deccan Their presence with their painters produced a revolution in Bijapuri taste. In the Mughal art portraits and depiction of historical events predominated, and the artist's name and subject of the painting were identified by the given inscriptions. The Deccan artists, usually anonymous, choosing above all to create a mood, used extravagantly unrealistic colors and shapes. Portrait did exist, but conventional ideas of beauty were more important than physical likeness of the subject, who is really identified by inscriptions. It was in the reign of Sultan Muhammad Adil Shah that the interest shifted from ideal forms to real people. Mughal style portraits with subjects against a dark background, restrained in line and color, gained popularity. Bijapuri artists became aware of the stylistic trends at the Mughal court. A good example of the painting of the type is of Sultan Ibrahim Adil Shah II appearing at a palace window to courtier Bijapur, dated to 1620 to 1630, and Edwin and Binney III collection, Sultan Muhammad Adil Shah. Most Bijapuri paintings from then on is brilliantly ornamented but lacks romanticism of earlier work. There is also a new interest in historical record. Several paintings of the mid-17th century are signed and are dated. Under the patronage of Ali and Sikandar, the synthesis of Mughal and Deccani taste, which had begun during the reign of Mughal Adil Shah, 1627 to 1656 AD, found a new direction. Besides portraits, figures smoking hookahs, smelling flowers, or reading scrolls were painted. One of the most lyrical paintings of the period is the Darbar of Sultan Ali Adil Shah II, attributed to Bombay painter, dated 1660, in the collection of Dr. Moti Chandr, shows the emperor surrounded by courtiers, stiffly standing to attention in glittering halls. He is holding the coat from bed in a relaxed way, smoking his beedi, hookah. In the collection of Barber Institute, Birmingham, England, is a superb portrait of Ali attributed to the Bombay painter, dated 1660. He shown wearing a splendid gold jama, decorated with emerald green peacock feather. Another painting of Sultan Ali Adil Shah II, dated to 1600, aiming an arrow at a tiger, is at present in a private collection, is also a painting by Bombay artist. Inscribed Ali Adil Shah, Emperor Bijapur, 1660, in a private collection, is also painted by on cloth, remounted on paper at Kishangarh. Another painting in the Musée Guimet, Paris, is of a courtesan holding betel leaves, attributed to the Bombay painter and inscribed as Abdul Hamid Nakash or Amal A, work of Muhammad Nakash, Bijapur, 1660 AD. The courtesan is shown wearing a gold pajama, a transparent mauve, and a gauzy pink veil against a dark green background. Prince Muhammad Hashim, son of Sultan Adil Shah II, Bijapuri, 1670 to 1680, in the Cave Collection, London, is shown as a young man whose beard is not fully grown. The Metropolitan Museum of Art, New York, has a signed painting by Kamal Muhammad and Chan Muhammad, titled Sultans of Adil Shahi Dynasty. To the left of Sultan Yusuf, 1487 to 1509 AD, are from right to left 1509 to 1534 AD, Ibrahim I, 1534 to 1557 AD, Ali I, 1557 to 1579 AD, while on the right are from left to right Sultan Ibrahim II, 1579 to 1627 AD, Muhammad, 1627 to 1656 AD, Ali II, 1656 to 1672 AD, and Sikandar Adil Shah, from 1672 to 1686, dark skin shown as a child. Sultan Adil Shah II with Courtesian, 1660 to 1670 AD, and Sultan Sikandar Adil Shah, fanned by a page, 1680 AD, in the Paris collection, is the dark skinned child king ruling at that time. In 1686, when the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb captured the city and its Sultan, the Royal Bijapur School of Painting ended abruptly. Aurangzeb destroyed all the paintings in Adil Shah's place. Few examples of Bijapur paintings are The Attraction of Music, dated to 1630, ink and opaque watercolor on paper and in the collection of Virginia Museum of Fine Arts. Translation of inscription in Persian gold script on lower left corner of drawing, artist Manohar. This drawing depicts a female ascetic yogini who sits playing a veena in the wilderness, surrounded by birds, beasts, reptiles and fish. Most of the animals are shown in pairs. Some crouch on rocks, seem to swirl around the yogini. Others emerge from a stream that winds from the left center into the foreground. Fine lines and delicate washes are heightened here and there with color and gold. Stylistic analysis suggests that this drawing was produced about 1630 in Bijapur. During this period, Bijapur artists were heavily influenced by the Mughal pictorial art. Another painting is a scene based on the Last Supper or the marriage at Cana, belonging to 1640 to 1660 AD and in the collection of British Library, Johnson Album No. 6. This mysterious and introspective composition with artistic traditions, indigenous, Indian, Persian, Mughal, Turkish and European, contributed to the evolution of a painting styles in Bijapur. A yogini belonging to Bijapur, dated to 1640 and is present in the collection of Victoria and Albert Museum. This enigmatic figure of yogini, a female mendicant, enveloped in a certain otherworldly landscape, evoked a mood of dizzying melancholy. Another painting is a leaf from Nizam-ul-Ulam Encyclopedia, Stars of Sciences, belonging to Bijapur School, dated to 1570 AD. Under Prince Adil Shah I, Bijapuri, Nizam-ul-Ulam was illustrated. The miniatures in this book seem to derive from the wall paintings of the Vijayanagar Empire. Persian combination of calligraphy and illustration is found. The figures in the illustration here are in the mixed Hindu-Persian style. The flowing pallav of the costume being almost like of Niyamat Nama scarves, while the two heads are crowned with Persian style caps. The stems of brown grass on the pale purple background are of Deccani inspiration. Ibrahim Adil Shah II of Bijapur, patron of the arts, who ruled from 1580 to 1626 AD, is dated to 1590 to 1595. The painting has lively composition and fine draftsmanship influenced by Mughal portraits.